time for the Bengals and the Chiefs, a rematch of last year's AFC title game won in overtime by Cincinnati.
They were riding hot. They beat us three times in a row. I definitely heard all that stuff. Burrowhead and the mayor, he said that Joe Burrow was my dad and they had to like take a paternity test, which is, I mean, just wild. You never expect someone in that position to be trash-talking like that. Just gave us a little bit extra motivation to go out there and lay it on the line.
What's up, Nicole? Huh? Michael, what's good?
Yeah, you see him? He's over there. How you doing? He threw the bomb. He just threw the bomb. Whoa.
Normally, this type of high ankle sprain takes 3 to 6 weeks to recover from. Patrick Mahomes is out here after just 8 days.
I feel good, baby. 3 hours of greatness. Woo-hoo! Love you.
Hey, you got this. Let's go, buddy.
Yeah.
You
want to
stand up? Daddy, that is Daddy.
The AFC Championship game is underway. Here is Patrick Mahomes playing with a high ankle sprain.
Come on, Eddie.
35. At least now I'm in the shot. Y'all can't even see that shit.
To the left side.
Obviously, but when you're playing against a great team, know that those field goals aren't going to be enough.
We got to finish with seven, okay?
Got to get in the end zone. One play at a time, get in the end zone.
The Chiefs have had two possessions but two field goals. Fourth down and a yard for the Chiefs.
13!
And a shotgun. They roll it to the right side. Mahomes is running. Now fires it late for the end zone.
Step up in the pocket like I wanted to, so I just tried to do whatever I could to get a lane to throw it, and of course I threw it and I was fine, but landing back on that ankle didn't feel great, so as much as you wanted to celebrate, I was like, let me just get to the sideline as quickly as possible.
Yeah. And now the PAT by Butker. It is good.
Oh boy, Holmes, how limited is he going to be with the high ankle sprain?
Great job! Great fucking job! We're not done! Great fucking job!
All right, boys, let's go! Put the game away! Come on!
7:02 to go in the game. 20-20 tie. Another nail biter between these two. Burrow going to throw it long. Coming down near side, T. Higgins. It's knocked away and intercepted!
To the very end. He's such a competitor.
Give me 2 minutes for the win. Let's go. Go.
Who will represent the AFC in the Super Bowl? 2 minutes to determine it in regulation. Third down and eight. Cincinnati Burrow retreating.
And there is going to be sacked. Down he goes.
Come out. Come out. Come out.
And the Chiefs will call timeout at 39 seconds left in regulation.
Holy shit. Come on, 15.
This is what I've got.
I like them all. Just keep calling them, coach. I'm going to get the ball in my hand. I'm going to get the guys. Ready to get in field goal range. Let's go. Ready to get in field goal range.
We are in the AFC Championship with the winning seconds of regulation. 30 seconds remaining in a 20-20 tie.
All you're thinking is, can we get us our game-winning field goal?
Let's do it.
They're looking to get into field goal range to kick their way into the Super Bowl.
A field goal is all we need. Come on.
Ball's on one leg. Dumps it, and the pass is going to be caught by Pacheco near side. Gets tackled in play.
Hey, come out.
Come on, Patrick. 85. Come on, babe.
We had 17 seconds. That's kind of that gray area that you got to get a completion. You got to spike the ball with no timeouts, or you got to throw it towards the sideline.
17 seconds left in regulation.
Adrenaline kicked in. I just went for it.
Go Blue! We got it!
Mahomes trying to buy some time on that bad ankle. Moving to his right. He is now scrambling, and he's going to get a first down.
Mahomes gets hit late!
Mahomes gets hit late! It'll be a 15-yard penalty on top of the game. And they're going to move it all the way down to the Cincinnati 23-yard line.
You're a warrior. You got it. I'm good. Take
it. Fire,
fire, fire.
Let's go!
You're not thinking about your ankle. All you're thinking about is, what can I do to give our team a chance to win the football game? And that's the competitor that I am.
Remaining in regulation of the AFC Championship game.
Kick it!
It would be a 41-yard field goal attempt. This will be a 45-yard attempt. Harrison Butker, the biggest kick of his Chiefs life. The spinning kick high, floating in the air, and it is gone!
So many great football games, but we hadn't beat the Bengals. It was definitely a satisfying feeling.
Just an incredible performance by Patrick Mahomes. Now he's got 2 weeks to get healthier.
Have fun. This is your favorite. I know you love this stuff. Have so much fun. I know you love this stuff now. Okay, I will. Hey, I've been all week.
I don't say a word. It's like grinding out. I got what I deserve. Hold on, wait a minute.
Hey, in case you didn't know, just in case, we're going to the Super Bowl.
Enjoy it tomorrow, but then we right back on it. The job's not finished.
No, it's not.
So Chiefs on three, 1, 2, 3.
Super Bowl week is finally upon us. It's all going down in Arizona. Super Bowl 57 featuring the Kansas City Chiefs.
he's a fascinating one.
I believe in Jalen Hurts. I believe he will make a few more plays than Patrick Mahomes.
Also, the Philadelphia Eagles, oh my God, this unbelievable defense.
And they are healthy, and that defensive line just put a beating on the 49ers.
They are a physical bull.
I look at them and I say, they're the best team. Like, they should win this football game. Only one problem. Patrick Mahomes.
I don't know. Like, Mahomes' ankles, he gonna be able to move around and do the things necessary.
Welcome in to Super Bowl opening night, and what a matchup we have in Super Bowl 57.
How you doing?
Good, man. How are
you? Good seeing you. Good seeing you. Good seeing you, man. Opening nights, it's wild, man. You're there for like two or three hours of just getting the media done in order to prepare for the week of football.
Kansas City Chiefs.
Watched it on the couch with my daughter and with my wife. I had to make sure that I used my time wisely, and so I was actually studying like formations and coverages that the Eagles play.
Before the event, and to be honest, I'm a competitor. I was a little upset that I wasn't invited to honors. You know, I'm going to Phoenix, and they didn't even invite me. We had the largest comeback in NFL history, won 13 games, and our coach is not up for Coach of the Year, and the quarterback wasn't even invited to honors. And then I got the call that said, would you like to go to honors? And I said, well, yeah, I'd like to go to honors. It's a little late, but sure, I'd like to go. And then a couple hours later, I got a call that said, would you like to sing at honors? And I said, hold on, 2 hours ago, I wasn't even going to honors. Now you want me singing? But I saw George Kittle's dad on my flight to Phoenix, and I brought it up to him, and Mr. Kittle said, you know, Kirk, it's good to be uncomfortable. And I thought, you know, he's right. That resonated with me, and so I thought, I'm going to be uncomfortable doing this, but that's okay. And so I got off the flight. I emailed him back and said, I'll do it. And an hour later, we were at rehearsal.
Daddy,
Daddy.
Leave
that there.
Daddy, Daddy.
Okay, we have MVP coming up, Man of the Year as well. So let's get right to it. Are you kidding me?
time he's hurt.
I'm sorry, Kelly. I just wanted to sing one quick tribute song to Tom Brady on behalf of all the other quarterbacks in our league.
All right, Sean, play like a diamond. Okay, okay.
Tom's won 7 times, went to 10. He's on some beast, so maybe Kirk could win.
Ash! Ash, what's going on?
You can really sing. What? Wait, you got it? Okay. Okay, Kirk Cousins. I'm totally pressed my button. Okay.
You're my daddy. He sees you being wild.
Can you be careful, please?
Rowdy girl.
It's time for one of the biggest awards of the night. Please welcome 2-time NFL MVP, Kurt Warner, y'all.
Daddy's about to win. Can you watch?
In the 2022 AP, the most valuable player is Patrick Mahomes.
For giving me this platform and putting so many amazing people around me to help support this dream I've had since I was a little kid.
To my wife, Brittany, my baby girl, Sterling.
Thank you for always being there for me through my good times and my bad. Love y'all.
We love you.
I was able to win the MVP, which is a special honor. It's so hard to really appreciate it till after the season because you know that ultimate goal of winning the Super Bowl is still right there.
You ready to go to bed?
Right there.
You ready to go to bed now?
You watch football? Okay.
I watch football.
It is Super Bowl weekend, everyone, right here in the Valley of the Sun. We want to welcome you to the 2023 Super Bowl breakfast.
Yeah. Every year I've gone to the Super Bowl for different events and not been a part of the game. It'd be a shame to finish your career and have never gone to Super Bowl week with the right reasons to actually play in the game, and that's certainly the goal. But this year, I had the chance to be recipient of the Bart Starr Award. You know, it's a tremendous honor to win that award.
Can I get my youth flag football coach in here? Can I get my flag football coach in here? Good to see you, coach.
Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Stay there.
The Bart Starr Award is given every year to an NFL player who they believe best exemplifies character and integrity, not only on the field, but in the home and in the community. If you want to sum up the life of Bart Starr in a few words, you would say things like leader, respected, humble, coachable, hardworking, persevering, faithful, loving husband, and devoted father. Who doesn't want these words said about them at the end of their life? However, you'd miss something very significant about Bart Starr if you also left out the word Christian. He understood, just as I do today, football will one day end. Life will be based on much more than football. You play this game for team awards, and the individual awards are going to come on occasion, but for me and the individual awards I've won, this one would be the most meaningful to me because of what it represents. It's an honor to receive an award in his name. I can only hope at the end of my life to have someone speak of me as we have spoken of him today.
Started the season with one goal in mind, and now the two best teams stand one win away from glory. Coast to coast and around the world, it is Super Bowl 57, live from State Farm Stadium in Arizona, for the right to win the Vince Lombardi Trophy. Here are the Chiefs, third Super Bowl in 4 years, against the team that has really dominated the NFC side, the Philadelphia Eagles.
I actually thought it was a better feeling to be in that third Super Bowl. I was more satisfied. I was like, hey, like, all that work you're putting in every year, that hasn't paid off. It paid off this year to get to this game. Now let's go out there and win it.
All you gotta do is be us, baby. Us is good enough. Let's go do it, baby.
Ain't this what they've been waiting for?
Kansas City Chiefs.
You ready?
And the Philadelphia Eagles.
Super Bowl 57. I used to pray for times like this, to rhyme like this, so I had to grind like that, to shine like this. See, my dreams are full, nightmares come true. It was time to marry the game, and I said, yeah, I do. If you want it, you gotta see it with a clear eye view. You
got to show the shot of the like I said, I do.
Song that I usually listen to get myself ready to go every week, and I didn't listen to it because I was like, it's an Eagles song, like he's saying,
right.
I did it without an album. I did it with Mariah. Look, I'm on fire.
This is a heckling feeling, nigga, I'm flying.
And I'm sitting there warming up for the game, and it comes on, and I'm like, all right, like I know it's their song, but it's getting us turned too.
I'll say a word, I'm on my grind.
That you don't know exactly when it's going to hit you, that you're in the Super Bowl, that you're playing in the biggest game of your life, and it all starts to hit you what this moment is.
Hey, embrace this moment. Everything we work for is for this moment.
Right here.
Embrace that shit. Everything you got for the guy standing beside you. It's going to take everybody. Let's go up there and find a way to drag our ass across the finish line. Let's go win a game. Chiefs on three, 1, 2, 3.
There he comes, man.
After 2 weeks of waiting,
yeah, all day, baby. Let's do it,
Whoa.
Baby.
We are finally ready to start this game.
The 57th Super Bowl is underway.
Watching football? Now I'm watching football. Are we watching football?
Down and goal to go for the Eagles at the 1.5-yard line of Kansas City. It is a 1-yard quarterback sneak by Jalen Hurts. 7-0 Philadelphia.
Come on, man. Do your thing.
14 to go first quarter. Mahomes in the pocket. Floats a pass near side. Kelce over the shoulder. He's got the catch. He's got the touchdown.
That's all fucking day, dog. That's all fucking day.
This game is tied
at 7. Keep rolling. We do what we do.
That's right. We do what we do. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And now the Eagles, they're moving at the Kansas City 45. Hurts wants to throw, and he's throwing long for A.J. Brown.
Oh, shit.
Hurts back to it, catches it. Touchdown, Philadelphia Eagles. But they got a 7-point lead again.
One punch, then another punch. It's been a lively first half.
Come on, D. Give us a turnover or something.
By himself in the shotgun, there's the quarterback, Hurts, 36 from his own 48. He'll try to blast his way, he finds the ball. It's bobbling and loose. It's picked up by Fulton, the 30, 5, 20, 10, 4, touchdown! Hurts, the fumble. We're tied at 14.
Hey, big bomb play, you right back on it, dog.
2:39 to go. Chiefs have had just one possession in this second quarter.
Shotgun snap, Hurts will run, got a ball from the ground. He wants it, touchdown. And he's propelled the Eagles to a 21-14 lead with 2:20 to play in the first half.
Let's go score, man. Let's go do it. Let's go do it, man. Let's go. Let's go put one in over the half, baby. Here we go. Right in 2 minutes. Let's get it, baby. Love the fucking moment, man.
It was a third down. The momentum was on their side, so I wanted to put it on the line and make a play happen.
Now the Chiefs have third and 15 at their own 31-yard line, trailing 21-14.
I kind of faked it like I was going to pitch it. I feel like I had a chance to go get that first down.
Woo!
And he's hurt.
for Patrick Mahomes. What we were afraid of.
Yeah.
For me, it was right before half, so I didn't have to go back out there before the half.
Burns 24, Chiefs 14.
And Patrick Mahomes will tend to that ankle.
If Mahomes' ankle injury is as bad as the grimace on the sideline indicated, that really could hurt Kansas City.
He had that long halftime, so I was able to take my shoe completely off, cut the tape off, get it moving again, get that mobility a little bit back, and then mentally prepare myself to go out there and play that second half.
We know that we are capable of coming back from any deficit at any time, and there's not going to be anybody freaking out in the locker room.
My halftime message was, I felt like we weren't beating ourselves. I felt like we were playing in the Super Bowl, not like we're just playing the game of football. And I wanted to tell the guys, I was like, we just have to go out there and love the game, and show that energy, show that love for the game that everybody's come to know for the Kansas City Chiefs.
To win this game, I know.
I think just having that rest, that time to kind of let the ankle and that sensation kind of settle down a little bit. All right, I know it hurt. Let's mentally tell yourself that you can finish just one more half of football, then you can worry about it in the offseason.
The Chiefs will have the ball to start the third quarter.
We've been in this position before, so we know what we can do to respond. I just told myself, let's just go out there and play. Let's leave it all on the line and find a way to give our team a chance to win the game.
I need that energy, O-line. Let's go.
Chiefs get it first, and we'll see Mahomes right away. I mean, he's going to play. He's going to gut it out. He's tough. We'll see how it affects him.
Let's dash.
We knew it was going to be a big first drive, and so I feel like just me getting in that huddle and just not even talking about the ankle, not doing anything, it just showed the guys that I'm going to put it all out there.
Here we go. Hey, come on, you're good. All right, so big target right, you left, 96, counterclockwise.
It's that mobility that is so key to his game and making some big plays, so obviously something we're going to pay attention to here in the second half.
And he's going to have a first to Pepo. Mahomes looking all right on the ankle there.
Come on, baby. Come on, Patrick.
In the gun, Mahomes. Second down, three. Ball to 18 of Philadelphia.
Okay.
Running around. Looking, that's going to take off. That's the first down. Still on his feet. Mahomes down to the five. Well, forget about the angle. Somehow he's gotten through it.
I think that run told me that angle was going to be good enough to go and finish this game.
Touchdown. Opening possession of the second half. Patrick Mahomes, you know that ankle hurts.
Let's go. Get right in.
But he took him 75 yards for the score.
Good shot. Let's go. Good shit.
Patrick Mahomes had a 14-yard scramble on third down, showing that the ankle was okay.
Yes. We're going everything. When we get the ball, we go score. We go score a fucking touchdown. Let's go.
We start the fourth quarter. Eagles 27, Chiefs 21, Kansas City on the move. First and 10 at the Eagle 43-yard line. Ball's that side over the middle. That's his man. It's caught by Smith-Schuster.
Sorry,
sometimes will call run plays, knowing we're going to go for it on fourth down. And so he called that play, but it also has a pass option on it, and they always tell me, if it's there, just take it. Originally, I was probably going to hand the ball off, knowing that we were going to have a fourth down scenario, but the way we had drawn it up, it worked perfectly like I had done it in practice all week long, and they try to pass off the motion, which they're really good at doing, but we hadn't shown the fake motion and back out.
Kadarius Toney couldn't be more wide open, and the Chiefs have their first lead of the game.
What's up, Jaden?
You feel a ton of momentum. You can just feel like it's starting to happen. Like, everything we worked for is starting to happen.
Just the second punt of the day for Philadelphia.
Come catch it. You're good. You're good. Let's go. Was supposed to take the attention off of Wiley.
Go.
And then I remember right before the play, number 22 pointed right at Wiley and was like, hey, I got him. And I was like, well, this play is definitely not going to work.
Oh, well, here we go. Sky Moore in motion. Mahomes, what's he going to do? He's going to throw for the end zone. Incomplete.
Come on, Patrick. We got to score.
It's third down. Goal to go. At the 4-yard line of Philadelphia.
Hey, Mike, he's down to White. It's cover zero.
A fast left side wide open. Sky Moore, touchdown. Kansas City. A 4-yard touchdown pass for Holmes to Sky Moore.
Let me keep that ball. Keep that ball.
Kansas City 35, Philadelphia 27.
I looked out the motion and I realized that we didn't have the formation right.
The play we were rolling formation.
I saw they were in cover zero and I just knew this play was literally perfect for cover zero. And so I was like, all right, let's roll with it. And so I motioned Sky.
Man, wide open. Touchdown, Chiefs, and Sky Moore.
I was trying to get the cover zero protected.
Hey, Mike, he's down to White. It's cover zero. And then I looked out to the right and tried to motion. KT pointed that way. I was like, hey, we're not done, bro. This shit, hey, let's go. Let's fucking go. Let's go. Let's go. I'm gonna stop right here.
You're right. What's been on, bro?
it's just the adrenaline. You don't think about it when you're playing. Just mentally tell yourself you gotta go out there and be a competitor and win the football game and just push through it. Score a touchdown or get down there close and kick a field goal with time running out.
Comes fourth quarter clock at 1:54. We're tied at 35. Third down, 8. Chiefs with a 15 in Philadelphia.
Did it twice.
Oh man, that is a game altering penalty. Kansas City's in control of the clock for sure now.
Charge mode. So don't score.
McKinnon on a counter. Left side at the 10.
Go down!
Angling to the 5, and he's going to slide down at the 1. Very smart inbounds. The clock will move.
Yes. Time management, baby.
Call timeout at 11 seconds to go in Super Bowl 57. It'll be a 27-yard field goal try for Harrison Butker.
Yeah, I gotta watch this real fast. Oh my God. Come on, buddy.
Celebrating because those people have supported you through thick and thin. To when you win it, they're always there, and so to see the joy in their faces is more special than the joy that you're feeling.
Hey, we're playing the Super Bowl. Do you understand that?
Ah.
The first quarterback in NFL history, Mahomes, to win the MVP during the regular season, be on the number one scoring team in total offense, and win the Super Bowl.
I'm going to Disneyland.
You're the most talented I've ever seen.
I appreciate that. Yes, sir. I got to keep Coach Reed around for a while. I'm going. I ain't letting him go anywhere. Hey, you see Coach Reed? She knows you, too. She can point at it. Oh!
There was two moments for me. I think the first one was when I sat on the field and my daughter was there, and because she wasn't at the first Super Bowl that we won.
Have a kiss. I love you. You on the football field? You on the football field?
And I always knew that I wanted her to be a part of it and get to experience being on the field, even though she might not ever really remember it. And then I was able to hug my dad after both Super Bowls.
Hey, let me go to my dad. Let me go talk to my dad.
City says, I've never seen anything like you. It's surreal because I mean, I grew up and that was my hero. He played in professional baseball and it still hasn't sunk in with me of winning two Super Bowls.
Ladies and gentlemen, Super Bowl 57, MVP Patrick Mahomes.
I just want to shout out my teammates, man. We challenged each other. It took everybody to win this football game. So shout out my teammates, baby. We're Super Bowl champs, baby. Let's go.
Hey, brother. Hell of a game, man. Hell of a game, man. Keep leading those dudes, man. You're a hell of a player, dog. Yes, sir. Hell of a game, dog. Yes, sir.
I love you, dog.
Yes, sir.
You,
yes, sir.
Way to lead those boys, my brother.
Yes, sir.
Hey. Ah! Two of them.
I know. Two of them. We ain't done, though.
Hey.
We ain't done.
Hey. Woo!
Ah! Ah! Man, it's so special. Just because I don't think it's even winning the game. It's all the hard work paying off. You put in so much work that people don't see.
Went to the last game, huh? I love you, dog. Way to get up in there.
I was able to win the Super Bowl with a brand new group of guys. I mean, I think only like 10 or 11 guys were on the team that won the first Super Bowl with us. To experience that with them, the guys that hadn't been in that experience before, it was special. It's just something you can remember the rest of your life.
Oh, goodness. Not even... Okay, I can't even sit in. Hasn't even sank in yet.
No.
I'm so proud of those dudes, man. I got, like, no sleep, and then you fly to Disneyland, then you're, like, you're sitting there with Mickey and Minnie, and you're just, like, looking around, just like, this is surreal. Watching the Super Bowl one year, and then the quarterback's just like, I'm going to Disneyland. Such a simple phrase, but being able to say that and being on top of the world, I'm glad that I've been able to say it twice now. I spent the day at Disneyland, and then you go to Jimmy Kimmel, and all of a sudden you're on that, and you're like, how am I even in this position?
Please welcome the MVP, number 15 in the flesh, Patrick Mahomes.
Can I get you an ottoman for the ankle? Is it okay or is it all right?
Oh, you saw me. I was cutting up there. I'm ready to play a game today if we need to.
Are you?
It's still all right.
I want to ask you about one particular play. Let's roll that play then. Okay.
It almost looks like a Jewish wedding reception or something, you know, when you did it.
We worked on that play for so long, and then I knew we tried to disguise it with all that different stuff happening before the snap.
What is that play called?
So Wiley, who is the guy we were trying to get the ball to, is a big Pokemon collector.
Uh-huh.
And so it was a Pikachu formation, and it was called Gotta Catch 'Em All.
Nice.
I fell asleep on a nap ride over from Disneyland to here, so that was my sleep. And I get one day off to get my rest, and then the parade on Wednesday, Chiefs Kingdom, I'm ready to see you there.
And now you got two beautiful
balls. Yeah, kids.
I'll make sure to put them right next to each other in the trophy case.
Eagles, as we look at our defending conference champions here, they went out and got themselves a new backup. Marcus Mariota is the new backup behind Jalen Hurts.
Good morning. Hi, how you doing?
Good.
You've moved to Philadelphia.
I am, yes, far.
Well, you better get some warm clothes.
Exactly.
We will.
When do you go?
In a couple weeks.
It's far. It's cold, but I'm excited.
I was really hoping for something west. I was, trying to come back closer to home. And Philadelphia was very supportive, and to be a part of a team like that, a play for winning the Super Bowl is really special for me. And I'm looking forward to the opportunity to work with Jalen and the rest of the team and just try to make an impact wherever I can.
I feel like there's a little bit of a gradual process to go from the end of one season to the next. When the Super Bowl is over, and that's when you know it's time to move forward. But even then, there's a little bit of that buffer of, hold on, I'm not quite ready to dig into the next year yet. I need to just catch my breath.
This is the division championship t-shirt and hat that I knew when I got it, it would be going in this memory room when I got back home to Michigan. While that was a special day, part of a special season, I'd like to think there's still more out there to go get. This little notch in the room was meant for a Super Bowl trophy. I'd like to have to move all this out someday to make room for a Lombardi trophy.
Next is you enjoy the offseason. The first about month, you enjoy those times with the family and friends.
Right to the fish tank, baby.
Our best friends, for their housewarming gift, they wanted to get us some cool fish, which is an amazing housewarming gift.
They got this cool,
so
fast
they got
ones
us
right
these
here.
Little guys. Oh,
that's my favorite one, the long tail. He flies around here. And then Sterling's favorite is Nemo.
Yes.
We are already named him Nemo, and
that's his corner.
That is his corner. Pass to me, babe. Come on. See it. Good pass.
Nice.
What you learn about when you play in the Super Bowl is that all season's short. You can have that parade as many times as you can.
Kansas City with the world series tagging it. Hell yeah! We ain't done yet.
And so you already get back to working out because the goal is to win the Super Bowl every year that you have the chance to. When I get done with my career, I just want to look back and say I have no regrets of how I've worked and what I've put out there in order to have as much success as possible.
My name's Taylor.
The fuck?
Oh! Hey! We read the wrong.
So you get drafted. What are your first impressions of Tom Brady?
Dude's handsome.
Do you know what you and a lobster have in common?
Well, hello there.
Surprisingly, a lot. And in this video, you'll learn what a lobster can teach about spiritual ascension and the five main traps that the lobster ascension process. One of those traps will probably surprise you. And trust me, you don't want to block your ascension because it's a fundamental spiritual process that leads to your highest destiny in life. But first, what the heck is ascension? Ascension literally means that your human self, both your physical body and your energy system, starts increasing in energetic frequency to a higher, pure energy. Another way of saying this is that the human self begins to embody higher concentrations of light. One way of seeing ascension is through the ancient spiritual tradition of Egyptian alchemy. They use the term ka body as a part of your soul that looks like your physical body but is made up of energy. This is why the ka body is referred to in Egyptian alchemy as the etheric twin. It's made of light and hovers around the surface of the skin. The higher your vibration, the more light you embody and ascend, the stronger your ka body gets. This has many powerful repercussions in your life. You become more powerful manifester, you feel more joy, you experience higher states of consciousness, and you live out your highest destiny on Earth. This ka body can be so powerful that it can be even seen with the physical eyes. Some spiritual teachers even consider the biblical story of the resurrection when Mary Magdalene saw Jesus after his death as the perfect example of just how powerful the ka body can be, especially in an ascended master. After his death, Mary Magdalene was the first person to see Yeshua outside of his tomb, and it wasn't his physical body she was seeing. It was his ka body that was so powerful it could be seen with the naked eye even after the death of the physical body. And although for most of us our ka bodies never get as strong as Yeshua's, they can get very powerful nonetheless, and that happens through the process known as ascension. So ascension to me means expansion. It also means evolution. And that brings us to the lobster. There's no animal on earth that illustrates the intricacy of the ascension process better than the lobster. When you learn how the lobster grows, you'll understand everything you need to know about ascension. In stage one, during the growth process, what's known as pre-molting, the lobster begins to feel uncomfortable inside its shell because its soft body is outgrowing the fixed outer hard shell. When this happens, the lobster starts to absorb calcium from the shell into its soft body, and the shell slowly starts to weaken. In stage two, the lobster takes in large amounts of water and its body expands, increasing the weight 50 to 100% and cracking the hard shell open. Stage three, then it pushes itself out of the old shell. Once free, it's extremely vulnerable because its new shell is soft, so it hides under a rock or in a hole. In stage four, in this vulnerable place, the lobster grows rapidly while the shell is still soft. And by the time the shell hardens, the lobster is a much bigger and expanded version of what it was before. This is what ascension looks like for us humans too. In stage one, we begin to feel uncomfortable in our lives. We feel constricted, like something wants to emerge from us. It's an automatic deep sensation that comes from our souls. When we start feeling this discomfort, we draw in and become highly aware of our wounds and the things that need to change in us. We also learn lessons that our old dying selves have to teach, and we draw those lessons into our hearts, much like the lobster does when they draw calcium from the hard shell in. In stage two, as we do our spiritual healing work, our ka bodies begin to expand beyond the energy of the old self, like the lobster does when it takes in water, and our old self cracks open, freeing a new version of you. In stage three, you can feel so vulnerable with this new energy because you're more sensitive and feeling. So you may go into a phase known as hermit mode, withdrawing from society, or just temporarily going into periods of solitude like the lobster does when he hides under a rock with his new soft shell. In stage four, once the old self is released and broken through, your human self starts absorbing higher concentrations of light, and you grow spiritually in an accelerated pace, just like the lobster does when its shell is still soft. Once your new ascended self takes hold, your energy stabilizes and you feel like a new person ready to take on the world, just like the lobster does as he comes out from under the rock when his shell hardens. This is the essence of ascension, and I felt this so many times in my life. There have been many moments when I felt that discomfort of my inner self becoming bigger than my outer surroundings. I felt stuck in relationships and connections that I knew deep down I was outgrowing. I felt stuck in my career, knowing that my soul wanted to do something more than I was doing at the time as a clinician. I still feel those moments of temporary tightness when my inner self goes through an ascension period and the outer world has to be adjusted to fit my new expanded self. And here's the truth. These ascension phases never stop. Throughout your entire life, you'll have many moments of ascension just like the lobster does. Fun fact for perspective, a lobster molts on average about 25 times in its first 7 years of life. So imagine how many times you'll go through ascension in your long life. But before you freak out at all the ascension phases you'll go through over the course of your life, because I know how uncomfortable they can be, remember that the more prepared and informed you are about ascension, which you're doing with this video, the easier ascension phases will become. Especially when you understand the top 5 blocks or traps that can pop up during ascension phases, which can make the process so much more painful than it needs to be. And before we get into the 5 blocks, I designed something to help you discover which one of these blocks of ascension is dominant in your life right now and how to heal that block. I've designed a free quiz called the Ascension Block Quiz. You'll receive a score for the most dominant block operating in your life right now, and also video and meditation resources to help you heal that block quickly. Click on the link in the description box below to take that quiz after watching this video. The first block is unhealed trauma. When you have painful past experiences and trauma that have not been addressed or worked through, you can easily be triggered, and this presents a problem during ascension. When you're triggered without knowing why or where that trigger comes from, you become highly volatile and lack the emotional maturity to understand the deeper meaning of the trigger. Unhealed trauma and emotional immaturity mean you can be very resistant to change because your body and mind are constantly looking for security as a way to keep you safe. Now imagine that the lobster had unhealed trauma. It would never want to leave the security of its first hard shell, and it would probably just die asphyxiated by a shell that was too small for its growing body. This is what unhealed trauma can do to you during ascension phases. Your human self resists cracking through your old self and merging into something new, and the more your body resists, the more uncomfortable your body becomes. The second block is dysregulated nervous system. This is very closely related to the first block because a dysregulated nervous system usually comes from some form of unhealed trauma or past experience. And when we talk about dysregulated nervous system, what we mean is that your nervous system is out of balance. Usually, the part of your nervous system that is putting you in a state of dysregulation is excessive activation of what's known as the sympathetic nervous system, which is your nervous system of fight or flight. It's a part of the nervous system that's responsible for getting you out of danger. It tends to kick in when you're threatened. The sympathetic nervous system works hand in hand with another aspect of your nervous system called the parasympathetic nervous system. When your nervous system is dysregulated, what that really means is that your sympathetic nervous system is overly dominant, and this presents a problem, because when that sympathetic nervous system is too dominant, what ends up happening is that you're in a constant state of fight or flight. There are more sympathetic nervous system responses, not just fight or flight, but the ones that are most pertinent for the ascension process are the fight or flight response and what's known as the freeze response. When fight or flight is activated, you're going to either punch someone in the face to defend yourself, or you're going to run away. But then there's also freeze, and this response is very common in people who experience childhood trauma because a child doesn't have the possibility to run away or fight against an aggressor, which is usually an adult. So what ends up happening is that the child will use the freeze response much more commonly, and this can then translate into them using freeze responses excessively as adults also. When it comes to the ascension process, when you have either fight or flight or the freeze mode in action, you will really resist or block the ascension process. When the ascension process becomes very uncomfortable, especially in those first stages, kind of like the lobster when they feel uncomfortable right before they crack through the shell, there's nothing inherently wrong with that discomfort, and the lobster knows it. The lobster's nature is inherently knowing that discomfort does not mean anything bad is happening. They're not dying. Nothing dangerous is happening. It's just a phase of their growth. Humans, though, because we have trauma and we have ego coming in, we have beliefs, we have thoughts, we have all these things coming in, all kinds of layers to our being, we can interpret discomfort as danger. And when you interpret discomfort as danger, your nervous system will ring the alarms. It'll go into fight or flight or into freeze state. And when you are in excessive sympathetic nervous system activity, it's very difficult for you to go through the spiritual processes that are necessary, especially during ascension phases. Ascension requires the use of another part of your nervous system called the parasympathetic nervous system, which is the system of peacefulness, calm, rest, relaxation, and learning. It's the state of taking in information, learning new things, and being open to new opportunities. This is all coming from the parasympathetic, so if my nervous system is excessively in sympathetic activity, all that it's going to be thinking about is let me get out of danger. It will not be open to new experiences, new opportunities, and new energy, which is exactly what's coming in during an ascension process. So if your nervous system is dysregulated, you can be certain that your mind and body and your whole human avatar will be resisting the ascension process. And it's kind of like a lobster trying to hide inside of its old shell instead of cracking through. Imagine how painful it would be for the lobster if it were to try and hold itself inside of the old shell that no longer fits it. And that's what ends up happening when we have a dysregulated nervous system and it takes over the spiritual processes and your ascension process. It creates a lot of discomfort and it can create a lot of physical symptoms like tightness, severe pain, headaches. You can even manifest physical disease or ailments in the body through this resistance. Imagine all of this new light trying to come in as you're ascending, but then your body is locked up and not letting that light come in. It can be a nightmare for the body. The third block is ego resistance. Now we're moving from the body into the mind. The ego is that part of you that has a sense of self or a personality. It's the part of you that says, I am, or I do this, or I believe this. When you're going through an ascension process, if that ego is not trained, if your mind isn't flexible, if your personality isn't flexible, if your ego is really hardened, it will block your ascension. Remember that the ego can be more hardened if you've gone through a lot of trauma that's unhealed. Because when you experience trauma, your ego will form in a very controlling way. I don't know if this has happened to you or if you've ever met anyone in your life who's gone through a lot of trauma and they have to control everything in their lives. Mm-hmm. So they have to know exactly where they're going. They have to have their house set up in a certain way that feels safe to them. They have to control every detail of their lives. These are just some examples of what happens when the ego takes over and becomes highly, highly inflexible and controlling, coming from trauma that's unhealed or not worked through. The more resistant and controlling your ego is, the more it will resist the ascension process.
Be real.
The lobster story, imagine how vulnerable it is when it emerges from the old shell. It's very sensitive and vulnerable, and suddenly it's feeling the world in a totally different way than it felt with the hard shell on top of it. And it's the same thing for us when we go through ascension processes. The new us is emerging from underneath our old selves, and it's very vulnerable. It's very sensitive. It's very new. It's experiencing the world in a totally new way again. In order for you to allow yourself to go into this new world, to this new version of yourself, your ego needs to be flexible. It needs to be pliable. It needs to not be in a position of control all the time, but in a position of an ally. This is really necessary for you to be able to move through the ascension processes with a lot of ease. So the more resistant, the more controlling your ego is, the more your personality thinks it knows everything and it has to know everything and it wants to stay in control of everything, then the ascension process will be a lot harder for you. Because guess what? The ego doesn't know anything about ascension.
Nope.
The ego has no idea who your new self is. It has no idea where your soul wants you to go. So there's no point in even allowing your ego to control the ascension process because it's not going to be able to do it. And it's only going to be creating stagnation in energy at the level of the mind and body. So always remember that for you to go through the ascension process with ease and with peace, your ego must be pliable, soft, flexible, and it must be an ally of your soul, not the part of you that wants to be in control of everything. The fourth block is fear. The reason I'm bringing up fear is because the vibration of fear is very low and can hinder your ascension. A little side note here is that no emotions are better than others. All emotions are welcomed, honored, and necessary. The full spectrum of emotions is necessary in the human experience, and they all have their place. But emotions do have different vibrations, ranging from really high vibrations like ecstasy and joy to really low vibrations like fear, guilt, and shame. I'm sure that you've felt this in your body before. Fear or anger feels very differently than love, wonder, and ecstasy. We all know these things feel differently in our bodies. And why do they feel differently in our bodies? It's because these are fundamentally different vibrations. The lower you go on vibration, the more constricting to the body and to the energy field. So if you stay in the vibration of fear for too long without processing it or letting it circulate, it will more than likely affect the ascension process because the vibration of fear is very low compared to the vibration of the light codes. When fear and other lower vibration emotions are acknowledged and properly circulated in the body, they transform quickly, so your overall vibration does not stay low. The problem starts when we stay in the vibration of fear constantly over a long period of time. This will block the ascension process and it creates an energy tear inside your body because part of your being is trying to ascend while the other part is pulling you down into lower vibration. So the key here is that fear is healthy in short bursts, but toxic when felt continuously. The fifth block, and the one that may surprise you, is sedentarism. Sedentarism is surprising because so many people do not realize that a sedentary lifestyle or being sedentary is very problematic for spiritual awakening, especially for ascension phases. During an ascension phase, you move energy more quickly, you expand, you evolve more quickly. If you have any type of sedentary lifestyle, it's going to be a huge block for your ascension process because when your body is taking in all that new light, when you're expanding beyond the limits of what you were before, this requires an extraordinary movement of energy. So going back to our lobster friend, remember the part where the lobster takes in a lot of water and it expands its soft body and that's how it cracks open the hard shell? You can think of this taking water as an intake of energy. So for us, when we're going through an ascension process, we take in so much new energy and it helps us expand our cells and our new being, but that energy must be moving. This is a fundamental rule in spiritual alchemy. Energy hates stagnation. Energy needs to be on the move always. So imagine if I'm going through an ascension process and I get home from work feeling all of these symptoms of the ascension, and I just plop myself in front of a TV and grab my PlayStation, and I spend the next 5 hours playing video games or scrolling through social media. That sedentary and motionless position of hours in the same place is going to block my ascension process. It's going to block energy inside of my body. It's going to create so many physical, psychological, and energy symptoms. The more sedentary I am, the more affected I'll be at the level of my body, mind, and energy system. Being sedentary is problematic for humans under normal circumstances, let alone during an ascension phase. Mm. During ascension, even more energy than normal needs to move. The more sedentary I am, the more difficult it will be for my new self to emerge. I'll also be damaging my poor body because it won't be able to circulate the energy needed in ascension, and stagnated energy can create many symptoms at the level of the mind and body. Body movement.
Shut the hell up, Smiley.
So get off your butt and off of your phone. Stop scrolling through social media for 5 hours every day. If you're working at a desk, make sure to get up
frequently. When the fuck are we working at again, bitch?
To make your life less sedentary. This can involve simple movements. It doesn't have to be anything
complicated. Shut your ass up.
But just move your body so that your energy can keep moving. The more energy you can flow within your body, the faster the ascension process.
Hey, bro, I ain't gonna hold you, bro. My braces gave out the other day, nigga. I'm mad as fuck.
If you're genuinely tired and that's why you're plopped on the couch, check out this video next, where you'll discover the surprising spiritual reason why you're feeling so tired of life right now, and the
ain't no way. How the fuck you take off an ad block? Bullshit ass shit. Bro, okay, like, so I tried to I put some DOT4 brake fluid in there and I'm thinking this shit was cool. I'm thinking shit cool. That shit still screaming. I'm like, damn.
Man, you went on a rant of just like,
I'm back to 40-hour weeks though, so I'm not shit. That's not gonna be a problem for me. I'm good.
Again, is what
you
did.
I'm not even trying to start this. You replied to someone who tweeted everything gets put up. So you get drafted. What are your first impressions of Tom Brady?
Dude's handsome.
Fucking tall and handsome.
I literally walked in through the locker room. I had my big ass like 20-inch binder of plays because we used to have playbooks.
Yeah, yep, yep.
I walked in, almost dropped it. I'm like, damn, he's tall. He's handsome. Like, you got Giselle. Hey, I'm Julian. Hi, Jules. I know you're Tom. I'm Tom.
Yeah.
I was like, damn. And then I remember the first day of practice, I saw this dude throw a ball. I was like,
no, yeah, for sure.
Just
dropped it right over the corner, a deep one to Moss.
Yeah.
And when you got to
see I think it's the pad, like, man. A young player. It's a break pad. Man.
It was fucking crazy. That's what he said. And then you'd see little Welker and he'd zip it like,
just like on sick.
I don't think a ball hit the ground.
Bro.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Because, like, I was driving home from the gym, and that shit, I had to start braking, like, 30 feet behind the vehicle. I'm like, bro, if somebody brake checks me, I'm fucked.
I never called it to his face because he was older and I was a rookie and everything. But he could scoot. He could get out there and run around. He did it at Utah. He was very precise on, like, the reads and everything. And that's where I started to understand, like, getting on the same page as the quarterback more and more. And understanding defense will help, like, me be on the same page with him. Now with Pat, the understanding of the structure and then the ability to just freelance and just obviously it's a structured freelance. You know when and when not to because of what everybody else is doing out there on the field. I feel like what you were saying earlier about Tom being able to tell you, hey, Jules, why don't you just hit it?
Your shit went flying out there. What the hell? When
you first got to the league, was it like that?
And what, by the time
you guys were leaving New England, where was it at?
It took me years to gain this trust. That was like the thing with Brady. When you're a fucking technician that's been doing it at a high level for such a long time, like, he already had, like, 11 years in the league when I got there.
Right.
He had three Super Bowls.
Yep.
You know what I mean? When you're a guy like that, you don't want to waste time. Every rep is something to those guys, so they want things done a certain way right away, the way it needs to be done, and if you don't, they fucking just, I'm done with that, give me someone that knows what they're doing.
Yeah.
You have a built-in pressure that you're like, oh, shit, I can't fuck this up, you know, as a young player. And so it took me years to get comfortable. It took me reps with him, which I didn't get a lot with.
Oh, that's what that was?
I moved out here because of him. Because he used to live out here. He used to train. We had the same agents. And I always heard about him having
I thought it was because you tried to fix it yourself or something. It was something else.
Beach, right off the one, and fucking lived there for 3 months. He called me one time. I told my agent, yo, let him know I'm in fucking town. I want to throw. And, like, I was a nobody at that time, so he wasn't going to, you know, like, he had his thing, and it's probably political. He can't have, I don't know, but
yeah.
Call me once. And fucking, I went out there, dropped everything, came out the next year, you know, called me a few more times. By year three, you know, we were throwing 3 or 4 times a week. And that's where I got to learn what he liked. And he learned my body mechanics. So he could tell when I was dropping my weight or how I was going to make a cut. Through reps and repetition, he could see my body language. He started to learn my body language. And once you get those reps in, then you throw in a defense and you start getting more reps against defense, then I become his eyes and he trusts me so much that if I turn out this way and I go like this, he knows there's not a defender out there even if he doesn't see it.
Yeah.
If he throws me in a certain area, you know, I know that sort of trust is built.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, you know, it's kind of like being eyes,
man. You don't get that without reps. All you young guys out there, like, I'm huge on finding a way to get out on the practice field no matter how my body feels.
Hell yeah. Yeah, they said you was on the YouTube. What's with that shit. I'm like, damn.
Ariel Beast, and y'all, check this out, man. What the fuck? So y'all, listen, today is my off day. I really don't have too much to do. To be honest with you, I have been resting. Y'all don't know, my body just feels so tired. And I just been feeling super duper tired. But it's all good in the hood, you know what I'm saying? So,
I gotta clean this phone case. This shit is filthy.
So, I'm thinking about going to Plaza America. I used to shop. I remember Plaza America, but I remember Sharps Town before they named it Plaza America, right? That was one of my favorite malls I grew up in, X, Y, and Z. My mom, my dad, we used to go there all the time. Like, even after Sharps Town, like, they changed the name or whatever. After the Macy's shut down, Dillard's, y'all listen, I remember
all that. Once I learned how to do this shit, man.
Y'all listen, I still go there town to town. No, I'm not going to buy no jewelry. I'm not gonna buy the expensive kind of.
I feel like it's a reason for this shit, there, bro.
I know my mom be going to certain little stores in there, but I have not been in that mall in a while. I'm not gonna
for
lie
sure.
to
y'all.
I just wanted to get up and do something, just probably be around the area, just to just vlog and talk to y'all, and you know what I'm saying, man. Just get my mind off of shit, you know. So, but yeah, y'all, because when I get back home. I'm gonna show y'all, I gotta upload 2 beats. Actually, I was so tired, y'all.
I gotta actually upload.
Hell yeah. Also, you know what to do for your shit too.
I also gotta make some packs. I really do. I need to make Lou another pack for sure. And I'm gonna clean. Like when I get back, I'm gonna settle down. I'm gonna clean. You know, clean up my closet. Cause I cleaned out the other part. I showed y'all a little bit of like studio stuff. I do gotta clean up my closet and clean out that part because y'all, I can't be in no cluttered ass shit. But I am going to y'all with me today, man. We're gonna see, we're gonna get into today. So yeah, y'all, I just want to enjoy my day, man. Get up out the house. I was like, man, I can't keep sleeping all day. I ain't got time for that. So hell yeah, y'all, it's currently 3:51 p.m. as we speak. Y'all been resting all morning, excuse me y'all, but everything all good, man. Everything all good, just trying to, you know, get through everything, y'all. So oh, by the way, y'all, I had took off, man, I thought this was sexy red, y'all. But look here, I had took off the wrap. Let me show y'all this real quick. I had took off the wrap. Ooh, y'all, just get y'all, ooh, got me scooty, scooty. Y'all, look, so I had took off the wrap, y'all. Let me show y'all wrap. So, I had took it off. Y'all, listen, my arm was itching so bad. Oh, my gosh. But it came, it was already peeling, so I just peeled off because I was itching so bad. And y'all, the one on behind my ear looks good. Cool. Yes. So, but yeah, y'all, it feels good. Goodness gracious. And I already know it has to peel and stuff like that, but this crap do itch, y'all, and I cannot be itching and scratching it, you know what I'm trying to say. But yeah, y'all, so I may record in Plaza America, I may not. But if I get anything, cop anything, man, y'all know I'm gonna show y'all. So I do have some bracelets coming in the mail. So I like the, I've always been into jewelry like this. I've always have. And y'all, sometimes ain't nothing wrong with being on some casual shit. Like I said, y'all seen my last vlog. I mean, not my last one, my birthday vlog, I even wore a thing. But y'all, I've always been to shit like this. Like always. Like I wanna be different to other people. You know what I'm saying? Just, you know, it's just my style, man, you know? Yeah, y'all, so I'm gonna see y'all in a little bit. All right, y'all, so let me tell y'all what's been going on. I just got out of my place, man. Taqueria, Los Napolis, if I'm the police, whatever. I ate some more tacos today, man. As y'all see, man, I went to the mall, man, behind me Plaza America, man. I found another one just like this one. I got two more of these. So, hell yeah, y'all. Y'all know I already got my chain on. I know what I'm saying. I'm just having a little chill day, chill moment. Y'all don't know what else to do. Like I said, I ain't really, really much to do out here, to be honest with you. But I did do a couple of little, you know, little errands and shit. I do need to go get some gas. But, y'all, everything been good. I ain't gonna lie. Everything been cool and, you know, getting everything together. But, yeah, y'all, I'm just trying to get everything right. You know, my mind, just a lot of stuff just been happening and going on, y'all. You know, and with me in particular. And I'm just really, really trying to do my best with everything. I really am. No one's fucking perfect, bro. You know, I have a lot of moments where, you know, I overthink, like, I don't start. You know, when school comes, I gotta see when I start that shit. But when school comes, I wanna be on my shit. Y'all, and doing this isolation mode that I feel like God has used me right now. Because, y'all, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. It's a lot that's going, I can't say it's a lot, but it is the way how I feel. You know, I feel empty. I feel, you know.